The first golden key is the jellyfish, representing the central nervous system in 360 degrees as a whole, which is the first system appearing 18 days after conception in every human being. Let us conceptualize the spine as a 24-ring circus on blocks. The spine being a strong column of tripod shock absorbers, protecting and cushioning the jellyfish as we move within the 24 rings. At the core of the physical body, beneath the organs, the 24 fixed bodies of the vertebrae or blocks, interspersed with the 23 discs like vents for shock absorption, form the fixed bony and cartilaginous column in the front with a pair of spinal joints toward the back, composes the strong column of tripod shock absorption for the jellyfish. Like a reservoir in the center, the stack of 24 vertebral rings, continuous with the inner skull volume at the top and the inner sacral volume at the bottom, forms one whole 360-degree inner compartment for the jellyfish to swim freely, ideally. Let us call this whole 360-degree inner cranial spinal sacral compartmental reservoir most simply the swimming pool. In terms of simple pressure and overall negative pressure, or the swimming pool in a vacuum state, like a sealed jar, is a compressed swimming pool, which will be called the baby pool. Because the baby pool, or the compressed spine, absorbs less shock, the body in a cumulatively compressed state of overall negative pressure outwardly manifests as stiffness, discomfort in the whole spectrum of said disease, orthodox and unorthodox. The nervous systems, being electromagnetic, are like electric fences that demand freedom. In this light, this pain or whatever dis-ease is really our friend, as the nerves act as a pressure gauge and circuit breaker relating to us the compressed state of the tissues of the physical body, telling us exactly when and where the compression is, and exactly when and where the decompression must take place so that regular cellular regeneration can occur. We can now see pain and discomfort as the inborn mechanism of protection for the tissues if we correctly interpret its signals as a friendly reminder and not the enemy to battle. We have two choices, compression or decompression of living human tissues in the physical body, with clearly two consequences of either compressing the living human tissues, the pool, and eventually the jellyfish at the very core, be it cumulatively in the living human tissues of the practitioner, the patient, or the self. Newton's law plays no favorites. Fortunately, there is only one more option available to decompress the living human tissues as space for the jellyfish to swim, the very space for cellular regeneration can only be created via the expansive decompressive action of the craniosacral mechanism, which will reestablish a positive expansive diffusive pressure within the inner cranial spinal sacral compartment for the jellyfish to swim freely, which outwardly manifests as more comfort, more ease, more energy, and thus more cells or living human tissue, equaling more time in terms of the potential length of our lives. It may be now crystal clear that if space equals time, decompressive treatment is the only option to create the space for regular cellular renewal. If the simple fact of the body's cumulative pressure dynamics were fully realized, we would live a lifestyle of treating the living human tissues of the physical body, be it ourselves or others, as gingerly and gently as a sponge cake. Conversely, positive expansive pressure or a decompressed expanding swimming pool will be called the Olympic pool, in which the jellyfish in 360 degrees has ample room to swim freely away from the compression of gravity primarily, besides the shock of our movements in positions of rest, for not only comfort, but overall energy efficiency, and most primarily, the space for new cells to generate, and the old cells to be cleared away. That's life.